retro fund, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to make a stock solution using juice. So the first material that we are going to use today is some juice pack, and we're going to use the red one. We'll also need some deionized water to dilute it a little bit. Because we're making a solution, we're going to need a volumetric flask. And to know the original volume of juice that we're using, we'll need a graduated cylinder. And finally, because we are making a solution and it is important that we do not exceed the marking on the volumetric flask, I will be using a pipette with a bulb. Now, in this case, for my experiment, I'm going to use a 50 milliliter volumetric flask, but you may use a larger or smaller one. Just make sure that you adjust your amounts accordingly. So let's get started. The first thing I am going to do is measure out approximately 12 milliliters of my juice concentrate. It is important that we get rid of all air pockets and bubbles. And in this case, I measured out 12.0 milliliters of my juice. So next, I am going to open up my volumetric flask, transfer my juice concentrate into it. Until now, it was really important that my graduated cylinder was as clean and dry as we could get it, because we needed to know that everything that we poured into it counted toward the volume of the juice. But now we still have some trace of the juice left in the graduated cylinder, so we're going to add the water into the graduated cylinder first without measuring its volume, just to rinse over all the solute in this case. We rinse the graduated cylinder and we transfer our solution carefully. It is best to rinse multiple times with small amounts of water than to rinse once with a large amount. And when our rinsing solution turns very clear, that is a good sign for us that we are done with the rinsing. And for the rest, we're simply going to add water into our volumetric flask. We occasionally swirl. And then we make sure to add enough water to get to the mark. And as we approach the mark on the volumetric flask, we switch to our pipette. And then we get really close to it. And now we have exactly 50.0 milliliters of solution. We know the original amount of solute that we added, even though it was from a juice concentrate. There are a couple ways in which we can find the exact concentration of the solution that we just made. One of which is to search for the concentration of the juice concentrate and simply do a dilution calculation. That will get us approximately in the right neighborhood. The other option is that we use the molar absorptivity value of the red food dye that is used in the juice concentrate. And from that value and the absorption of this solution, we can determine the concentration of our juice.